say thank you so much for doing this. I know it's been a long day and a long 18 years for you, so we appreciate your time. And you know, my first question is just how are you holding up?
Yeah, well, I think I'm holding up pretty well. It feels good. My son's here, right here on site with me, and that just makes me feel even stronger to have Natalie's brother, you know, because he's out there doing interviews too, and I'm like, so it feels good. I'm tired, but if it's a good tired.
You said after the hearing today, you called it, you felt victorious.
Yeah.
Tell me
yeah.
about that.
Because when I think back to who I was and what happened to me in 05 with Yaron, and I'm sitting there at the Holiday Inn at night, 4 a.m. in the morning, May 31st, 2005, and he was over me. He held all the power over me, and I was desperate and just begging him to give me Natalie, give her back, where is she? And then now I fast forwarded to 18, and I feel like I have the power and the victory over him. Because all he's going to hear is that jail cell door slam mm-hmm. to remind him he's a double murderer. So it feels very, I mean, that's like a weight is lifting, because we definitely came full circle to shift roles. So it feels very good.
How, over the years, not only have you had to deal with your own grief, but you were, you know, desperate for answers. We had this main suspect. And in the meantime, while you pushed and pushed, another young woman died. That must be devastating for you, as hard as you were trying to get him put away.
Yes, because in 05, I knew that he was responsible for her disappearance. I did not know, that, of course, anything that we know today. But I knew that he was definitely involved in her demise of her one way or the other. So that was in 05, Aruba let him go. 2010, I had him, Aruba let him go freely to Peru and bludgeon a second young girl to death. So I'm thinking, I did everything I could in 05 and 2010 to stop him, but Aruba did nothing besides be complicit with him and let him go. So, you know, that's why I feel like I can live with my decision that I got the answers that I wanted, even though, yes, it came with a plea agreement, but I did everything I knew to do to stop him in the beginning.
You got the confession that you wanted. You know now what he says happened.
Yeah.
And does it give you what you thought it would all these years that you've wanted to know those questions, that you wanted to have those questions answered?
It gives me more than what I thought I was going to have. And I never thought about it just being over, because there's been so many rabbit holes. I mean, they were just like a sea of rabbit holes, mm-hmm. swirling theories. And I was into all of them mm-hmm. because we didn't have anything. And I think we just began chasing these, you know, running down these rabbit holes repeatedly. So it's nice it's over. It's stopped. So my nightmare is over, and I've always said that not knowing, to me, since I've experienced that, is far worse and more tumultuous than the knowing, even as brutally hard as it is to your soul and heart.
Yeah. When he said those words, when he described what happened, he's lied to you in the past. We
right.
know that.
Yes.
Do you feel truth in it?
Yes, I do. And the reason why, because it was such a comprehensive, you know, and conclusive, you know, series of events that took place, including the polygraph, the proffer. I have all this team of the federal agents there. And so the people that came in from Miami, the people here in Birmingham, the U.S. prosecutor. And so I felt, yes. And I was fortunate that I was able to hear it real time as well. And I think that is, because I know the details of the story as well. So, yes. Very confident. I even met with the polygrapher that was able to spend time with him and obtain these results. So I feel 1,000% good and strong.
I think he apologized to you and your family today too. How do you receive that?
I heard it, but I feel like it's a hollow apology, because I don't think of a double murderer and someone who can extort money and make a mother of a child you murdered pay you money, you know. So it felt very hollow, it felt scripted, but that's okay. I think all, probably, especially murderers, found a priest in prison, they all seem to. So I think that's kind of normal.
Yeah. So what do you do from here? What's next?
What do I do from here? Well, I don't know yet. I thought I'd just kind of see what's on the agenda with Matt and my two grandchildren and kind of join life again. I feel like I've put a lot of things on hold in the back burner and taken second places. So I think it's going to be nice to kind of, you know, feel a little bit more normal in society to know that's put to rest. And I did what I set out I'd do in 05. And I think about the people that helped me, starting with Greta. And then all the people in between, from, like I said, the FBI Miami, the FBI in Birmingham, the U.S. Attorney's Office here, and prosecutor, I mean, Lloyd Peoples, and everyone, Catherine Crosby, everyone has really rallied together as a team to make this happen. And then even getting involved, George Seymour with Patriot Strategies, and his business associate, Mark, and I mean, I think of Peru. A good-hearted Peru. I mean, Dina Boluarte. I mean, so Peru, I mean, in the U.S., thank goodness we have goodwill, and they're passionate too and strong and wanted me to be able to have this opportunity. And so I'm grateful to Peru for giving me this opportunity.
You mentioned Matt. What's this been like for him growing up kind of in the shadow of this issue?
You know, I don't really know. But I know one thing. He definitely, I think, has Natalie living through him. I mean, he went on and became an airline pilot and just so accomplished. And I think somehow she's living her life through him. So, and but I think he's, as I said, that day I saw him June 9th, I went, oh, he's going to be okay. Mm-hmm. You know, yeah. When he walked up those steps, I was like, I'm done. I mean, even if I hadn't have gotten to today, I felt like that was justice right there, you know.
These sentences, I believe, are concurrent, right, with what he's serving in Peru. Is that correct?
Or, yes,
they
are.
So there's no real chance he's probably going to be back here serving time.
No.
Do you feel like, though, that wasn't your main goal?
That was not my goal, and that should be the goal of Aruba. That was their responsibility, not mine. I'm just the mother who wanted answers. It's Aruba that has the double murders on their hand, not me.
Do you feel like Natalie's resting easier now?
Or? I do. I think so, because I think she probably was hoping maybe I could enjoy a little bit of life left. 18 years, long time. I didn't need to be investigating it for the rest of my life.
Can you do it though? Can you put it behind you now? You've been doing it, like
yeah.
You said, for so long.
No,
it's over.
Yeah. There's no more rabbit holes to be pulled down. There's no more swirling theories. There's none of that chaotic running around anymore.
Well, we wish you the very best.
Thank you.
And hope you get to enjoy life a little bit.
And I think it's all kind of started, too, right here at home. So Birmingham lit the fire that just spread and helped me out. And everyone's been so amazingly supportive. So thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.
For your time
thank
today.
You.